Dear friends, welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. This is my third video. The topic is endocrine glands, especially the pituitary, the master of art glands. So in this video, I'm going to discuss the various features of pituitary. You go through it and give your valuable suggestions and comments also. Don't forget to subscribe this channel and share this channel to your friends. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. Today we will discuss a new chapter, a new topic, that is endocrine glands. You know, endocrine glands, these glands secrete hormones. They are carried to the target organ with the help of blood. This gland does not have ducts. So this is the special type of glands which is present inside the body, so it is called endocrine glands. So many endocrine glands are there. Out of this, the most important and interesting gland is there, that is called pituitary. So in this video, we are going to discuss the pituitary. The pituitary otherwise called hypophysis. This hypophysis, what is the significance? Where it was located? What is the structure? What is the function? We are going to discuss in detail in this video. Let's start. Hypophysis or pituitary gland. This pituitary gland, first, where it is located? So location at the base of the brain, at the base of the brain. You know, hypophysis means, hypo means below or under. Physis means to grow. So hypophysis means below, under, to grow. This is the meaning of hypophysis. This hypophysis, where is located? There, especially at the base of brain. You know, in brain, this is a bone. This is called sphenoid bone. Especially in the sphenoid bone, a place is there that is called cella tarsica. This is called cella tarsica. So this is the exact place where the pituitary is present. So we can say hypophysis, otherwise called pituitary gland. This gland located in cella tarsica. So this gland, otherwise called master of all endocrine glands. Why it is called master of all endocrine glands? So you know, various glands are there. One is thyroid gland, adrenal gland, pancreas, thymus, testes, ovaries. So a lot of glands are there. These glands are endocrine glands. So all these glands are regulated or controlled by this gland. So it controls all other glands. For example, thyroid gland. Next one, adrenal gland, pancreas, testes, ovaries. Testes and ovaries are reproductive organs. At the same time,
they act as endocrine glands. So these glands, especially thyroid, adrenal, pancreas, so these glands control the pituitary. So it is called master of all gland. So this gland present in cella tarsica. Cella tarsica can get a place which is present in the sphenoid bone. So it is otherwise called hypophysis. So next we are discussing hypophysis. What is the structure? So hypophysis. Already told, located in cella tarsica, oval in shape or pear shape, just 1 centimeter in diameter. 1 centimeter. It has 2 lobes. Oval shape or pear shape, 1 centimeter in diameter. It has 2 lobes, and one more thing, it has only 0.5 gram. The weight is only 0.5 gram, otherwise 500 milligram. Very small size, but this small size, only just 0.5 gram pituitary, is called master of gland because it has several regulatory functions on the other endocrine glands. So let us see. So location, I have seen where it was located in cella tarsica. What is the size? 1 centimeter in diameter. What is the weight? 0.5 gram only. So it has 2 lobes. It has 2 lobes. So based on these 2 lobes, it has 2 lobes. One is anterior in position, one is posterior in position. So 2 lobes are. These 2 lobes has different structure and functions. We will see and discuss in detail. So it has 2 lobes. One is anterior in position, one is posterior in position. So anterior lobe, it is posterior lobe. This anterior lobe is otherwise called adenohypophysis. Adenohypophysis. The posterior lobe, otherwise called neurohypophysis. Neurohypophysis. So it has 2 lobes. One is anterior lobe, one is posterior lobe. Anterior lobe otherwise called adenohypophysis. Posterior lobe otherwise called neurohypophysis. This adenohypophysis, again, it has 3 lobes. Again, it has 3 lobes. One, pars tuberalis. Pars tuberalis. And the second one is pars intermedia. The third one is pars distalis. So this anterior lobe, adenohypophysis, shortly you can say AHP, adenohypophysis. This adenohypophysis has 3 zones. One is pars tuberalis, pars intermedia, pars distalis. So this pars intermedia, especially the mammals, it was merged with pars distalis. So, in human beings, 2 functional lobes are there. One is pars tuberalis, pars distalis. Whereas pars intermedia only present in lower animals. Only in lower animals, Whereas in higher animals, especially in mammals, this zone will merge with postalis. This is the major portion of adenopoiesis. So next we will see that is called neurohypopoiesis. So this neurohypopoiesis is it is connected to the hypothalamus. It is connected to the hypothalamus. It secretes two hormones. These two hormones are secreted by neurohypopoiesis, not synthesized by neurohypopoiesis, whereas this hormone synthesized in hypothalamus. Hypothalamus. So these two hormones synthesize in hypothalamus, but it hormones are secreted here. It was stored here. This secretes two hormones. One is called ADH, or we can say anti-diuretic hormone, to oxytocin, or one more name is there, that is called vasopressin. So these two important hormones, one is called ADH, anti-diuretic hormone, other is called vasopressin, and one more hormone is called oxytocin. So these two hormones released from neurohypopoiesis, from this adenohypopoiesis, it secretes totally six hormones. So what are the six hormones of adenohypopoiesis? What are the two hormones of posterior neurohypopoiesis? We will discuss their function and structure in detail. This hypopoiesis or pituitary gland, otherwise called master of all gland. This is called master of all gland because it regulates the other glands. But this pituitary is controlled by one more structure, is called hypothalamus. Hypothalamus. So this pituitary controlled other gland, but this pituitary controlled by hypothalamus. It's a part of diencephalon. You know very well. It's a part of brain. This hypothalamus controls the pituitary. This pituitary controls the other gland. This is the structure. Whereas, so just imagine, this is hypothalamus. This is hypothalamus. This is hypothalamus. So, this hypothalamus controls the pituitary gland, whereas So two lobes are. This is pituitary. This is hypothalamus. It is hypopoiesis. It is called pituitary. It has two lobes. It is called anterior lobe. It is called adenohypopoiesis. It is posterior lobe. It is neurohypopoiesis. This neurohypopoiesis, otherwise called pars nervosa. It's called pars nervosa. So two lobes are there. These two lobes of pituitary attached with the hypothalamus. This is the hypothalamus. With a small stalk. This is a stalk is there, this region. This is a stalk. So this pituitary attached to the hypothalamus with the help of a small stalk. This stalk is called infundibulum. Infundibulum. Now, during embryonic development, what happens? This anterior lobe, adenohypopoiesis, this part develops from the pharynx region of embryo. So it is called adenohypopoiesis. Whereas this posterior lobe arises during embryonic development from the hypothalamus. So this is originate or develop from this is called Ratke's pouch. Rathke's pose. This derived from Rathke's pose during embryonic stage. But this neuroapoplexis, pars nervosa, developed the outgrowth of hypothalamus. It was contained the nervous tissues. So it is called neurohypoplexis. So far we have discussed what is hypoplexis. It is called most of our gland. Where it is located? In cellular trisica. Cellular trisica, nothing but it is a place in the sphenoid bone. This hypoplexis has two lobes. One is anterior lobe, one is called posterior lobe. One is called adenohypoplexis, one is called neurohypoplexis. What is the size? 1 cm. What is the weight? 0.5 gram only. So these two lobes are attached to the hypothalamus with the help of a small stalk called infundibulum. So this is a structure of pituitary.